Was that Edie who just walked by?
Yes, it was.
Joker is going to have a field day with this.
You're positive you don't want to come over and talk?
No, the gun battery is nice and quiet. If I throw down some rugs, it'll get downright cozy.
Gareth?
I'll be fine, Liara. Just gathering some thoughts.
All right. Hello again, Shepard. What have you been up to since we last saw each other?
Since you helped me defeat the Shadow Broker, I started looking for defenses against the Reapers. The Protheans were the only ones with substantial information on them. The older civilizations barely had records. I knew the elusive man was hunting for the same thing when our agents began crossing paths.
Like on Mars.
I thought I'd covered my tracks, but he had surveillance there all along.
How much do you know about this Prothean artifact?
Very little. We're fortunate enough data survived to piece together the blueprints. Decoding them will require as many specialists as we can find.
It's that high-tech?
I'd have killed for a glimpse of it during graduate school.
You brought your little helper with you?
Its name is Glyph. It helped sort through all the data that led me to the archive on Mars.
It was a pleasure to be of assistance, Doctor.
Glyph's interfaced with the data feeds. Its analytical software should come in handy.
What's been happening with you as the Broker, Liara?
It's been exciting. The old Broker's ship, impressive, but it was never meant to be spaceworthy. Which meant the elusive man eventually tracked me down on Hagalaz.
What happened?
I knew he was coming. Ferron and I loaded as much of the ship's specialized hardware onto a shuttle as we could. We got away from Cerberus's ships after arranging an appropriate distraction.
What kind of distraction?
Sending the Broker's ship exploding into a Cerberus cruiser. I don't think the elusive man expected me to give up my resources in such a spectacular fashion.
Can you still operate as the Broker without the ship?
Well, I couldn't let the elusive man have it. I saved what was crucial. My network of agents is intact, although the Reapers have taken a toll on their numbers. It's taking a while to re-establish contact.
So where is Ferron if you two escaped?
He convinced me he was recovered enough to work, and I do need more agents.
Agent Ferron didn't report any injuries during his last call to you, Doctor.
True. Given what he survived, I should probably worry less.
We'll talk later, Liara.
Of course.
Something on your mind?
Just old memories. I spent a few weeks on Palavin's South Peaks when I was very, very young. A Turian there teased me a little, saying that the mountains went on forever. I remember believing him. When I looked up at Palavin from its moon, I saw those same mountains burning.
Two of our dreadnoughts have been lost in a matter of hours.
I know, Primarch. I'm seeing the same numbers myself. They don't look good.
We have to turn this around, and fast.
Well, you can trust Shepard, sir. If anybody can get the Krogan to cooperate, it's her. She's an old friend of Erdnot Rex.
Let's just hope friendship still counts for something in this war.
I'm sure it will, sir.
Gareth. Didn't waste any time getting to work, I see.
After what I've been through lately, calibrating a giant gun is a vacation. Gives me something to focus on.
We're gonna need you for more than your aim.
Oh, I'm ready for it. But I'm pretty sure we'll still need giant guns. And lots of them.
Can't argue with that.
Yeah, so, is this the part where we shake hands? Wasn't sure about the protocol on reunions, or if you even still felt the same way about me. The scars are starting to fade. I remember they drove you wild. But I can go out and get all new ones if it'll help.
I haven't forgotten our time together.
Well, I've been doing some more research on human customs. I didn't want to...
That's the protocol on reunions.
The vids mentioned it might go something like that. I had hoped it would. I mean, I didn't know if...
I can't promise how things will work out. Not with this war. But I missed you, Garrus. I thought about you a lot.
Glad to know my romantic, skills made an impression. Because it's going to take more than Reapers to come between this cross-species liaison.
Speaking of which, you said you're the expert advisor on Reapers now?
It's not as impressive as it sounds. I ruffled some feathers, so they gave me a token title, along with a token task force, so I'd shut up.
How'd you manage that?
Just followed your example, Shepard. Yell loud enough, and someone will eventually come over to see what all the fuss is about. Not that they'll actually do anything about it.
Until hell shows up at their door. Then they put you in charge.
Not like the old days, is it? Rogue Spectre and CSEC agents running and gunning outside the lines, making it up as we went along. We're actually respectable now.
Yeah. I have a feeling that respect comes with a lot of sleepless nights. I can't even count how many lives are depending on us, Garrus.
Well, when things are looking grim, and I'm pretty sure they will, just remember, we're in this together. And if it ends with both of us dying in a giant explosion taking out a Reaper, remember I took the kill shot. Something else you want to talk about?
You mentioned you still had family on Palavin.
My father is there. Sister, too.
How long's it been since you heard from them?
Long enough to be worried.
I'm sure they're okay.
That's the thing about getting old, Shepard. The platitudes get just as old. Pretty soon, blind hope is all we'll have left, and I hate being blind.
I know you don't have any illusions about what we're up against, Garrus. How do you rate our chances?
I know it looks bad now, but I think we can win this, Shepard. For the first time since we met, we're not alone in the fight. It's something I learned long ago in CSEC. An imminent and painful death has a way of motivating people. Instead of questioning your every word, whole civilizations are going to be begging you to save them.
After what's happened to Palavin, you still believe that?
I didn't say there wouldn't be casualties. It's something Turians are taught from birth. If just one survivor is left standing at the end of a war, then the fight was worth it. But humans want to save everyone. In this war, that's not going to happen.
So what's this Reaper task force you've been running?
After what happened to you out there in Batarian space, I knew time was running out. For all of us. The Citadel Council was a dead end, so I did something I never thought I'd do. I went to my father.
He used to work for CSEC, didn't he? I seem to remember that the two of you didn't see eye to eye.
To put it mildly. But he still had heavy pull in the Turian government. The Primarch, well, the old one, was a friend of his. So I went to my father and laid out everything we knew about the Reapers, from Saren all the way to the Collector base.
I'm not sure even I'd believe it.
I had to admit that parts of it sounded crazy, meeting Vigil, talking to Sovereign on Vermeier. But my father just listened. It's what he did in his days at CSEC, putting together all the pieces. If the connections were there, he wouldn't deny them. And he saw what we always knew. The Reapers were coming.
I'm glad someone finally agreed.
He did more than agree. He took it to the Primarch.
I like his style.
Except the Primarch wasn't as convinced. My father kept pushing and finally got him to commit some token resources. And if you call them a task force, it sounds like you did something about it.
What'd you do with it?
As much as I could get away with. And a little more. We hardened our lines of communications, expanded emergency stockpiles across the colonies, improved our early warning detection protocols.
You think it helped?
I'd like to think it bought our fleet some extra time. We'll know when this war is over.
So you can vouch for this new Primarch?
Well, even if I couldn't, you go to war with the army you have.
Will he live up to his word?
I've never known Victus to lie. Play fast and loose with strategy, maybe, but betray an ally. Not his style. Then if he did try, well, we'll just find another Primarch.
I noticed generals saluting you, Garrus. How far down the line of secession are you these days?
Let's not go there.
Why not? I've seen you in action. Think about it. Primarch Vakarian, honored war hero. Somebody's gonna have to rebuild Palavin when this is over.
Your confidence is inspiring, but It'll have to be someone who knows how to hold the hammer.
That's all for now, Garrus. But stay close. We've got some catching up to do.
Do you know where to find me? And this time, I can afford the good stuff. There are a few perks to being an expert Reaper advisor.
Deal.
Now, I'm sure somebody screwed up something down here. I want to get the old girl back in fighting shape. Good to be back on board, Shepard. It's nice to see Liara again. I actually missed this place. Somehow, I always knew I'd see the Normandy again.
Commander, are you all right? It was fairly intense up here. I can only imagine what it was like down on that moon.
I thought you'd be more concerned about Edie.
Edie is a huge asset to this team. If she'd told me about her plan to obtain a body, I'd have volunteered to help.
I did not wish to force a conflict of interest between our friendship and your duty.
I'd have preferred a conflict of interest to a hard restart of half our systems. But thanks, regardless. While you're here, though, I found something while scanning Alliance channels. Grissom Academy is requesting help. The Reaper invasion front will hit them soon.
I thought the war would close most schools.
Grissom Academy is more specialized than a normal school. It's home to some of the smartest students humanity has to offer. Their Ascension Project helps gifted young biotics. If it had been open 20 years ago, I bet you'd have been there.
Yes, I sent a young man named David Archer there. I'm just surprised they're still open.
Some of their work has Alliance support. That might be why they stayed.
What can we do?
A Turian evac transport responded to their distress call, so normally I'd say we don't need to do anything. But something sounded off in the Turian signal. I had Edie perform an analysis. It's fake. Edie thinks it's Cerberus. She said the fake Turian signal was similar to the one that lured you to a collectorship?
Long story.
In any event, whoever faked the signal wants us to think Grissom Academy's being evacuated. But I believe they're still in danger.
Good catch. Maybe you belong here after all.
If this really is Cerberus, hopefully this operation is something worth investigating. It could be simple disinformation.
Trainer, good catch.
Thank you, Commander.